Good afternoon, everyone. It's really, really good to be here. And I think it's really good to be here with. Thank you. It's really good to be here in a conference organized by QStar that shows interest in a country from a bunch of international investors. And isn't that what we all want? And to have the opportunity to, you know, bring in more money and more business opportunities for Brazilian companies and for our market, and also opportunities to bring our companies to the globe. So it's really good to be here. Just wanted to tell you a little bit about Star Brazil, what it is. Briefly, just a background of myself. I'm not exactly the government guy. I've had 17 years of my career in the private sector, being an entrepreneur, and I've used several different hats in this ecosystem. So I've founded companies, I've been an investor, I've failed sometimes, I've had some exits as well. I've run one of the first accelerators in Brazil with not only digital companies, but also in other sectors. Eventually, we became the managers of one of the biggest seed funds in Brazil, that's Fundo Criatec. So we had 100 million reais under management, and we've evaluated thousands of companies and invested in quite a few of them. Then I felt that by seeing so many businesses that we were looking into invest, I tried to realize that we were lacking a lot of preparation, education on the entrepreneurs, especially in the digital space. So that's why I founded a Startup Farm, which is a kind of accelerator, but also I would call it a digital entrepreneurship school. So we're more willing to help entrepreneurs and to educate entrepreneurs into the challenges of bringing and building up a business. And then last year, the phone rang Sunday, and it was the Brazilian government invited me into to become the director of Startup Brazil, and to run the program and to design it. It's quite a big challenge, especially for someone who's not exactly used to the government side of things. So I joined the dark side of the force. It was quite challenging, quite curious, frustrating sometimes. The system, as you all know, is full of regulations and restrictions, but on the other hand, it's a great opportunity to do something for the country and for the ecosystem. I'm really glad to see here lots of companies that have been backed by Startup Brazil presenting and evolving and winning prizes and really growing their business, and that's what we are all here for. So just to give you a little bit of more information on what Startup Brazil is, it's a program held by the Brazilian government, by the Ministry of Science, Technology and Innovation. It's part of a major program called TI Maior, or Major IT, as I could say it, which was a very dense study that tried to see how we could evolve the IT industry in Brazil. And IT is a very cross industry, actually, so it can leverage many other industries and sectors. And we realized that we needed to foster the education and to have more people educated into the IT sector. It's a big problem, as you know. We need more professionals in that area here. And also, one of the main things was innovation. We need to have more innovation in IT in the country. And we found out, or the government found it out, that one of the main things to do that was to support entrepreneurship and support startups. So that's what Startup Brazil started. It's a program that basically funds and invests money in startups directly. And actually, one of the beauties, I think, of Startup Brazil is that it is a public-private partnership. So it's not just an action from the government, but in partnership with the private sector. What we realize it, but that governments are not quite good on knowing how to start a business. That's why we've partnered with accelerators. So we have now 9 accelerators that are partners of the program all over Brazil, and we're growing this number to 12 this year. And these accelerators are the one who actually host the companies that we support, give them office space, mentorship, market access, and many other business services to help them grow their business. And they also invest money. So actually, what we are investing money as government, and the accelerators are also investing or co-investing with us. And that way, we find ourselves much more aligned, because the success of those companies is the success of the accelerators. So we have them really involved into making those companies really succeed. These are our accelerators. As I mentioned, they're all over the country, and we're growing. One of the nice things about them is that we have different focused accelerators. So, for instance, we have one that is focused on mobile apps, another one that goes more into social businesses, and so on. And this variety of accelerators and of focuses is pretty good and interesting for us, because you can give to entrepreneurs different types of supports that could be more related to their real needs. And besides that, it's not just the acceleration process or the money. We try to offer some other services and support for those companies. One is a networking and learning events. We've made our first big event last year when we hosted all the companies, not just from Brazil, but from all over the world in Rio. And at that time, we had a super nice mentorship session with literally dozens of mentors at the same time. We are going to have another one in March this year. And what we've been trying to do is to bring to those companies not only a networking opportunity among themselves, and it's pretty valuable, be able to talk to other entrepreneurs that are facing the same challenges that you are, and exchange best practices and information. That's something that we are looking into improve over time, but also to bring them content, workshops, and more information as long as they need. We have a Silicon Valley International Hub. It's an office in San Francisco in the US, in the heart of the Silicon Valley. We have a co-working space there that our companies can use, and have been working on building up a network with investors, tech companies, and professionals over there, and to bridge both ecosystems. We're also going to host a demo day in San Francisco late this year. We have our demo days, as I've just mentioned. The first one will be held in Brazil by September, and we have then another one in San Francisco, the international version. We've also partnered with other programs like Startup Chile. So last year, we did a joint demo day, Startup Brazil and Startup Chile. Some of the companies here have been there in order to bring our companies to Latin American markets as well. And finally, access to market and investors. So as a government, we can open doors in large companies and even in the government for our companies. And that's something that we're trying to do even more this year. Just to give you a brief profile of what companies we have supported so far and how we've been working. On the last year, actually, we've had over 1,200 national applications and 414 international ones. And we've approved 118 startups from 37 countries and 24 Brazilian states. So it's a pretty good coverage. We've been able to reach all over the world and all over Brazil with very good companies. And if you see, out of almost 2,000 companies, we've picked 100. So it's a pretty narrowed selection. So we're very proud of the quality of our startups. And I have some of them here. You've just seen it. Well, it's not so good for you to read, but these are sectors. They're pretty, we have a wide range of sectors, from health, retail, events and tourism, health, finance, logistics, fashion, finance, and many other sectors. So very different kinds of startups that we've been supported. And in terms of development stage, on the first round, 82% of them already had a prototype, and this range have increased on the second round of companies. Over 90% of them already have a working prototype or a product that is running. So they're pretty good. This was the Welcome Aboard event that we did in Rio last year. We're going to have another one in March here in São Paulo, and I'd like to invite you all to participate. We still don't have the date, but I think we'll have it set over the next few weeks. And our demo days, this was the one that we did in Chile, and as I've mentioned, we'll have another one in Brazil and another one in San Francisco this year, probably another one in Colombia as well. As next steps, the new group of accelerators is being selected right now. We've received 24 proposals from accelerators from all over the country and a few international ones as well. And we expect to choose 12 of them. Late February, probably we'll release the results. The next round of applications starts in March. So every company that is interested can get to our website and apply to be able to receive this 200,000 actually, reais in grants plus the investment from the accelerator. That's the main benefit that we give. And we are going to host a demo day in Silicon Valley in the second semester. Just to finalize, one more thing, and I'm proud to say it firsthand here at the Ustart conference, we're going to have our venture partner network of Startup Brazil. So we're going to partner major investment funds, angel investors, angel groups, not only in Brazil, but also internationally, to bring them to our investment network. And those investors will have access to our portfolio, not only of the companies that were approved by Startup Brazil, but all the companies that have opt-in and to give their information for these investors when they apply to the program. So this way, I think that we're adding more value to the ecosystem and giving qualified information for qualified investors. And then we expect to generate more deals and more interest into our market. Well, that's it. Thank you very much and enjoy the conference.